Does the fear of rain, lightning, and glaciers keep you inside next to your cute little kitty cat?
Well, you can be better prepared for the outdoors with weather tips
from Weather Nerds.
It's almost impossible to predict the weather if we don't know what's going on above us. While it may be sunny and nice at sea level, at 5,000 meters, a weak storm could soon turn into something more dangerous. So how do we know what's going on above us? Well, if you don't want to head up and have a peek yourself, sending up a weather balloon could be one of the options. So today we're at NIWA's research station in Lauder to take a closer look at weather balloons, what they are and how they play an important role in weather forecasting. And we're lucky enough to have another weather nerd with us today to help us explain this more.
The balloons are made up of a couple of different parts. You've got your main balloon and you've got your payload, which in this case consists of what's called a radio sonde. There's the little device that measures pressure, temperature, humidity, wind speed, and we can then feed that into weather forecast models so that we know for the future what's going to happen. The highest one that we've launched from here was 38 kilometers in the atmosphere.
I'm so scared, it's so big!
So our balloons just go up until they burst, and when they pop, they just shred into little fragments. One of them came down in a little town and someone called up the police and called up the bomb squad because they thought it was a bomb. So since that day, we've had to have a little label on the top that says this package is not dangerous, so that we can actually maybe get people to send them back to us, because that would be really helpful. So the reason we continue to still use weather balloons is satellites provide some great data looking down through the atmosphere, but nothing quite compares to actually getting a physical reading of what's going on now. One of the other great things about weather balloons is all the information it can give us about other parts of the atmosphere, like the stratosphere, and that's where our ozone layer is. It's our main job we're actually looking at here at Lauder, is that ozone layer, that sunscreen layer, what's happening in there.
The contribution of weather balloons is as broad in scope as the heights they travel. It's a primary source of weather data above the ground. It helps drive forecasting models and give researchers greater insight about the atmosphere. Without these fascinating balloons, accurate forecasts beyond a few hours would be almost impossible.